All right, Dan, hey, this is the second video of the first one I did, activity levels. Now this is gonna be control to sale. And I think you and I, when we spoke about, you're like, what does that mean, like control to sale? And I know when I was in front of your folks, I know I referenced the Apple story. And I'll do it very briefly here again. But before I do it, I wanna make sure that controlling the sale really comes from a concept of this, is that to me, you're the doctor, you being the rep is the doctor. The customer is the patient. So of course, when you're in front of a doctor, they have a process, they ask questions, they're doing all the right stuff, they do the same stuff pretty much every time, and at the end of that meeting, they're pretty much going, okay, great, here's what you need to do. So they're kind of taking control, telling the patient, here's what you need to do to get better. That's the same thing that a sales rep does. So the doctor's controlling this, the patient's being told what to do, and then hopefully what the doctor does is hold them accountable, especially before you leave the office. Just before you leave the office, they usually go, great, make sure you book a time for your MRI or whatever you need, right? Well, the same concept is for sales. When you're on a sales call, pretty much when you get done, you're winding down the call, you want to make sure that there's some accountability and clear next steps. And here's where the gap runs in controlling the sales cycle. When I was in when I was with you folks in Chicago, we talked about my sales process, right? And that's the point we kind of started running short on time at the end. We talked about the sales process of, and I call it C2, D2. And the C2, D2 stands for connect, discover, deliver, and close. The connect part's really simple. That's just about likability, building rapport, talking about everything from the weather to sports to you name it. It's just a connection, okay? The discovery part is two types of questions. Strategic questions about their business, but then tactical questions about how they buy, okay? And that's gonna be a big part in terms of how do we keep control. This part here, deliver, that's when we start to deliver, here's how we do it, here's what we do and how we do, and the close is really about clear next steps to hold them accountable. And if you don't do this, we'll put it this way, if you don't do a good job in connect and asking great questions, then this seems a little odd when you start holding people accountable if you didn't do a great job up here. So when you say control the sale, and when you're with the doctor, this is a different world, I get this. You wanna know why? When you go to the doctor, you're going. The doctor didn't cold call you to try to get you to come in. I get that, you already have a need, that's why you're there. Hopefully if you've done a great job of that top-down approach, like what I talked about in your activity levels on the first video, if you've done a great job, you get the meeting or you're on a phone, then if you do a great job here, you're gonna motivate these people where you've earned the right to do these last two. I mean, it doesn't take a lot of right to do the delivery. Everybody's gonna listen to you talk about here's how we do it, but it's about that clear next step and holding them accountable. And of course, with the Apple story, you know, to net this out in 30 seconds, it was a manager getting on the phone, he showed up late. Hi, John, how are you? There's two other people as well. And by the end, now there's 3 minutes to go and he's got to go at 1:30. And he said, John, let me run it by my people. And that's the part where I went, uh-oh, I'm losing control of this cycle. And of course, I usually wrap that into something what my brain says is get him on the train because the train's leaving the station and they're not on it. And whenever that happens, I think one of the best things to do is this. You go right to this second set of questions going, hey, listen, right there. When you feel that you want to end the meeting, you want to control it, you want to go, hey, let me ask you really quick, how do you guys, and this tactical part is really about, this is simple. This is about budget, decision process, and timing. That's it. It's like, hey, so by the way, if I've had a great meeting, I've earned the right to ask about budget. Hey, so let me ask you, when you look at budget, and I say it this way, I don't care how much money you have. I just go, hey, when you look at budget, and decision process and timing, how do things go in here? And just stop, that's it. As they start to tell you, you'll start to map out how they do it, how they make a decision, what their process is like, and it's gonna be easier for you, for both of you to hold each other accountable, because remember, you're the doctor, you're trying to get the patient fixed. So in this world, it'd be like the patient going, let me run it by my wife, or my husband, or my significant other. Same thing for here, is that you might get, you know, once you ask these questions, they're gonna give you answers, and if they say, yeah, but let me get back to you, then all you do is you go right to the line I have on the laminated card, that card, and it says, I think I have the little plane, I have the plane, and the house, and the brick, and of course I do this just tongue in cheek, I laugh about it, but people remember it. It's kind of like, hey, if you don't say this line, I'm gonna get in a plane, come to your house, and hit you with a brick, right? Well, of course it's done in tongue in cheek, I'm trying to be coy about it, but at the end of the day, make sure you say this. So once you get this, you try to go, hey, listen, we didn't talk about budget, decision process, and timing, then right there, you then say, if the stars and the moon were to align, when would you want to do this? And I just did it this morning with a huge organization out west, and they actually told me, you know, they said April. And I said, okay, well, if it's April, we have to do a lot. And one of the first things I think you have to do is you have to make a decision here pretty quick, you know, who you're going to go with. Because if you don't, I won't be able to do April for you. So, and that's the same thing that you'll say to them. You're going to go, hey, if you want to do it then we got to get going. because all the steps it takes to finally get you up and running and going, not sign my deal by that time. It's like when the stars and the moon were to align, when would you want to have this up and running and going and worked out the kinks or anything? And it's going now. And when you do that, you then work backwards from that date, and it's easy. Now you are controlling the sales cycle. You're controlling the process like the doctor, and you're holding them accountable because they're their words. They told you. You're just reinforcing their words, and you continue to hold them, continue to move them forward. So that's controlling the sales cycle. You C2D2, make sure you say that line. And then right at that one point, right towards the end of a meeting, you want to go right to that second set of questions on Discover. Because one's strategic, but this is how they buy. And you're like, hey, listen, I haven't asked you just about money, decision process, and timing. Walk me through that. And they will tell you. See ya. Be good.